Loyalty to the Vanguard does not go unrewarded, Guardian. Be our eyes. Guardian, it's good to see you back in the tower. We'll need everyone for the fight ahead. Life changes very quickly in the last city. Before you join your fellow Guardians in the field, take the time to review past events on the timeline. Understanding the path that brought us here is the best way to equip yourself for what's to come. As any warlock might tell you, a little insight can level the playing field. It's yours. We stand behind you. Your wilting loyalty to the Vanguard is not going unnoticed.
Sorry, I'm late.
In times of crisis, people look to their leaders for answers. But ever since the planets were ripped from our sky, it seems all I can offer are more questions. And now, with Mars returned, I hardly know where to start. Where is she?
Your theory was correct. The relic is of the pyramids, there's no doubt.
Word is out about Mars.
I need more time.
The Cabal are mobilizing. We need to... Secure the camp!
It seems they have another target.
What are they aiming at?
Savathun.
Thank you.
Guardian, Eris and I are establishing hidden operations near the cradle. What's your location?
We're in some kind of crop field.
What you see is a window into the Golden Age. Mars has returned with temporal instabilities, and Savathun's presence here is no coincidence.
We believe the reappearance of Mars drove her out of hiding, and our intel says she may be in a weakened state. The Cabal fleet is blocking the flight path onto her ship. We need you to find a way to get up there and track Savathun down.
This may be our only chance to strike.
Cabal are setting up a giant cannon. I have an idea. Head inside and get me to a console. Bring me to the console. Let's see how this cannon works. I heard Savathun went into hiding thanks to the Awoken Queen, Mara Sav. So why is she showing herself again so soon? Seems too reckless for a god of cunning. Okay, got it. We need fuel, power, and projectile control. You'll be the projectile, of course. I know what you're thinking, but trust me, this will work. My plans always work. Let's start with opening the fuel lines.
Thank you.
One down, Guardian. One more to go. Lines open.
Next up, generators.
If I were a god of cunning, I wouldn't show up with a giant ship. It's like saying, here I am, come kill me. Or maybe Savathun's waving a red flag at a bull. Maybe we're the bull. We need two override codes to get the lift moving. Only Cabal engineers carry them. Get me to that console. I'll activate the lift. Is active. We just have to adjust the trajectory. When I was searching for the cannon schematics, I saw marching orders from Keitel. She wants to retake Mars as Cabal territory. Cannon is aligning. Time to reload, Guardian. Don't worry, you'll be fine. But I'll stand by to revive, just in case. To my knowledge, no Guardian has ever been on Sabathun's ship before. Either she's inviting us aboard, or she's so weak after that encounter with Queen Mara that she's getting clumsy. I'm hoping for the latter, but I wouldn't bet on it.
Yeah.
Cora. We made it onto the ship, and we're seeing traces of void light. Seems like maybe another Guardian got up here first.
That's impossible. Perhaps we've acted too hastily. There are too many unknowns.
Sabathun is the god of cunning. To wait for a moment when her intentions are clear, we would wait forever.
Not forever. Just until we can provide backup. Guardian, Eris and I are pinned down. If you turn back now, it'll give us more time to plan.
I don't think Sabathun will give us free time, Agora. This might be our only shot. Don't worry, we'll handle it.
Be careful.
You see that moth just now? It was glowing with light. Not corrupted light, Guardian, but light like ours.
Thank you.
Hive shouldn't be able to use the light against us. They shouldn't be able to use it at all. The Traveler would never grant them that power. Not willingly, anyway. This just isn't adding up. We need to find Savathun. Up unusual energy readings from that statue. Let's make a quick detour. Those moths will attack if you don't shoot them, Guardian. That statue doesn't look Hive. I've never seen anything like it. Looks like pyramid technology. What's it doing on Savathun's ship? We should bring it back to Ikora.
Thank you.
There are reports of Savathun trying to capture void light from dead guardians. Maybe this is related. Maybe she's been studying the void all this time. Could that be how she did this? That was Savathun. Hurry! No, that's impossible. Is that a ghost? It can't be. Get me closer, Guardian. I have to see. I can't believe it. That thing is not like me. You see that, right? End this, Guardian. I can't believe this. We have to keep going. Oh, Traveler, what has she done to you?
What is this place?
This doesn't look like a Hive throne world.
Tell me, O honored guest.
It's her.
How did you do it? How did you find the strength to destroy something so like yourself?
There.
To look in a mirror and kill what looks bad.
We'll be right back.
You're strong. That was too easy.
It did seem too easy, didn't it?
Guardian? Guardian, do you read me?
We're here, Ikora. We're back on Mars.
Back? From where?
Sabathun's throne world.
I know, we should have checked in. But we had Sabathun in our sights. That might have been our only shot at her, and we couldn't miss it.
I understand completely. That's not like Sabathun to allow herself to be seen so easily.
There's something else. Before we left the ship, we ran into one of her knights. And it...
It had a ghost, Ikora. Same as any other Lightbearer.
A ghost? A Hive Knight with a ghost? But that means...
Sabathun stole the light. But that's impossible, isn't it?
Impossible? With Sabathun, nothing is impossible.
Sabathun, the Witch Queen. Hive God of cunning and lies. Hive legend tells us she was born on a hostile, far-off planet, where she would have lived a short, uneventful life. If it weren't for the worm familiar that warned of an impending cataclysm. And so, she led her siblings into the depths, where the ancient worm gods offered them immeasurable power in exchange for endless blood tribute. From this, the Hive were born, and countless civilizations were condemned to extinction. For untold ages, they devoured life and light wherever it could be found, facing little resistance. Until they tried to take on the Guardians. After the death of her brother Oryx, Sabathun went into hiding. Not out of fear, of course, but out of strategy. Because Sabathun knows the best way to beat your enemy is to join them. In her greatest trick yet, she infiltrated the Vanguard, weakening us from within, and stealing our most sacred resource, the one thing we thought she could never touch, the light.
Thank you.
light-bearing hive, complete with their own ghosts. I should have seen this coming. But how? We're in a new paradigm now, Guardian, where the boundaries between are becoming increasingly blurred. Especially between what's right and what's wrong. If I had been in your place, to be honest, I don't know what I would have done. But there's no use dwelling on that. Let's assess what we do know. I see you picked up a clue along the way. One that might explain why Savathun decided to return alongside Mars. According to your ghost telemetry, that fragment is giving off the same vibrations as the pyramid tech relic. That just so happened to return with Mars. Go take a look. I'll explain more when you report back. Good luck. Up, out of the dark. My hidden are scattered and quiet. I need information, God.